to the OG. Dude be the OG. And he playing. Playing like a pro.
Succession is a show full of terrible people. The manipulator, the one who got away with murder, the one who helped make a fascist president of the country, and finally, the root of it all, Logan Roy. But what if I told you that Logan Roy isn't the worst character on Succession? And if Logan isn't, who is? Well, to understand why I say Logan isn't the worst character, we need to first understand all the reasons Logan is for a lot of people.
Romulus, when you laugh, please do it at the same volume as everyone else. We didn't get you from a hyena farm.
Thanks, Bob.
The first thing we need to acknowledge about Logan Roy is that he is the reason why the entire show happened in the first place. Without Logan, there is no Succession. He was the one who started the global Waystar Royco empire from nothing. But even more importantly, he was largely responsible for the one thing that made Succession so great, his fucked up kids. And that is the thing that makes Logan, in my opinion, the main antagonist in a series that is full of terrible, despicable people. Logan is a man that is all about one thing, the business. But to be a great businessman, he became a master schemer and manipulator, adopting the mentality that people are only useful to you for as long as they can help you achieve a certain goal. The problem is, Logan approached his kids with the exact same mentality, and you can see the effects heavily active in every single one of them. Logan's own constant lack of confidence in Ken's business acumen contributed heavily to Ken's lack of self-confidence and the slow annihilation of whatever was left of his mental health. With Roman, Logan's physical abuse of him as a child and Logan's extreme reactions to opposing opinions led to the development of an excuse for a man who could never stand up to his father. And Shiv, oh Shiv, Logan's constant manipulation tactics resulted in a person who knew how to do nothing other than scheme and manipulate others to get away. And that's my fellow. Oh wait, did I forget someone? Ah right, Connor Roy, I forgot Connor Roy. Just like Logan wished every day to forget Connor was his son. Add to that Logan's constant scheming that made it so that his kids always felt like they were competing with each other for his approval rather than learning to work together as a unit. And that, fellow Earthlings, is how you get Succession from the L to the OG, Logan Roy. So then, how can he not be the worst character? How can the guy who is the root of the entire show, the guy who was prepared to send his own son to jail, the guy who is sexist, almost definitely racist, responsible for some of the most irresponsible and biased news reporting that contributed to the massive division within the country and led up to the eventual potential election of a literally fascist president. How can that guy not be the worst of the worst? Well, that is because Logan is actually not as bad as you think. In fact, I believe Logan has been heavily misunderstood all along. See, Logan actually has some redeeming quality. Nah. I'm just kidding. Logan is one of the worst characters to ever show up on the TV screen.
Fuck off.
However, I stand by saying he isn't the worst character on Succession. And that is because there is someone on Succession who is even worse. But before I tell you who that is, leave a comment right now and let me know who you think the worst character on Succession is. And let's see if we agree. Now, for me, the person that I think is the worst of the worst, Queen Jezebel's mentor and the devil's protege is... Shiv Roy. Shiv Roy is a perfect example of the student becoming the master. Remember what I said about Logan's effect on Shiv? Well, Shiv saw all her father's manipulation tactics and said, I raised you by 1,000. Shiv is literally the most manipulative character in all of TV history. Dare I say, she's even more manipulative than the hybrid himself, Niklaus Michelsen. Yes! I said it.
You what?
You. Yes, you. I see you shaking your head and squeezing your face like a juiced orange. You're clearly not convinced, but that's fine because I can guarantee you'll definitely change your mind once we go over just a few of the many terrible things Shiv Roy did throughout the show. So, shall we? Shiv Roy, throughout the show's run, positioned herself as the progressive choice, the leftist woman fighting her way into the boys' club that is corporate America. Sustainability, women's rights, equality, and all that. Now, on two occasions, Shiv's progressive stance, particularly pertaining to women's rights, was put to the test. So then, how did she handle these situations? Well, the first case occurred during the cruises situation of season 2. You may have forgotten, but there was a victim of the Mo Lester and cruises cover-up willing to testify before Congress. Empress. And Shiv was sent by Logan, of course, to go speak to the woman. And what did dear Shivan do? She presented herself to the woman as the women's ally that she truly is, and then proceeded to scare her from testifying by bringing up every terrible thing that could possibly happen to her and her kid if she testifies.
And the good thing is, you're gonna have a lot of people on your side who will sing your name and back you up and... Yeah. But the other people, normal people, they will doubt you. We'll call you a slut, and a whore, and a money grubber. Your life is gonna get ripped apart.
That's right. Shiv supported women's rights by fear-mongering. What an ally. Wow. The second situation came up in season 3, when Logan found out that Roman had been sending raunchy sausage pigs to Jerry after Roman accidentally sent one of those pigs to his dad. Shiv comes in and tells her dad she's going to check with Jerry to make sure that there wasn't going to be a problem. Basically repeat what she did with the cruise's victim. Bury it. But then Shiv goes up to Jerry and instead blatantly suggests that Jerry files an HR complaint against Roman.
But Mr. Earthling, why would he shut down the first woman only to then suggest the exact opposite action to Jerry?
Good question, little Earthling. That is because in reality, Shiv didn't care about either of the female victims in these abuse cases. She only cared about how she could use these situations to her advantage. Confused? Let's break it down. In the first scenario, after Shiv convinced the cruise's victim to not testify, she went ahead and said this.
And I will destroy the men who ran that dirty operation. I will kill them for what they've done, and I want you to help me. We will be the best, cleanest operation in the world because of you. If you help me do this.
Stop the cap!
You see, in this situation, it was important for her to protect the company over the victim because the whole cruise's situation was her opportunity to break into the boys' club she felt she had unfairly been kept out of all her life. By positioning herself as the progressive choice, she took advantage of the horrific cruise's cover-up to get her fit in the company as a quote-unquote agent of change. Basically, she made herself the equivalent of the gay black best friend, there as a face to signify a change that in reality was nothing but a sandy beach on the coldest day in winter. However, with Jerry's sexual harassment, the opposite was the case. This time, Shiv was in a position of relative weakness, with Roman being the one in favor and the most obvious obstacle in her quest to be the true successor to Logan as CEO of Waystar Royco. Therefore, in this case, it was beneficial to her if Jerry pursued Roman to the fullest extent. She knew the kind of scandal that would create would make it close to impossible for Roman to be the next in line. And with the first son, Kendall, out of the picture, she would basically have a free run at the throne.
I'm the eldest son. I am the eldest son.
I am the eldest son.
All right.
I'm the eldest son. Okay. I'm the eldest son. But I am the eldest son. I am. I am.
In both cases, very clearly, Shiv was all for women empowerment, as long as the woman being empowered was herself. She never really cared for any of the victims, and in this sense, Shiv Roy is the perfect representation of the cesspit that is corporate America today. Progressive, as long as it benefits them. Are you convinced yet that Shiv is the worst? If your answer is no, that's fine, because I've got more. Not only is Shiv notorious for manipulating situations in her favor, she's also very adept at manipulating people. And while we could point to the multiple times she stabbed her brothers in the back, I think a perfect example of this was in the final episode of the entire show regarding the case of the British bartender who died in that car accident with Kendall. Previously, Kendall had confided in his siblings right at the end of season 3 about what had happened. And in season 3 and 4, his siblings, particularly Shiv, had reassured him that what happened was not his fault, at least not entirely. And while we can say they maybe said that to Kendall to help him get through his mental struggles, I don't think it would be unfair to say that they were actually right. That accident was equally as much the kid's fault as it was Kendall's. But then, when push came to shove, when things heated up, Shiv showed her true colors once again.
You can't be CEO. You can't, because you killed someone.
This, in my opinion, is one of the most despicable things a person can do. Can you imagine what it is like trusting someone, a sibling, family member, spouse, close friend, with one of your darkest secrets and deepest traumas, only for them to bring it up during an argument out of spite? This is who Shiv is, the kind of person to smile in your face and tell you she cares, but then use the information she gathered from gaining your trust as a weapon against you when she can't have her way. Shiv is the absolute bottom bottom of the barrel. All of these, in my eyes, already make Shiv one of the worst in a group of truly repulsive characters. But to you, this probably isn't enough to make her the absolute, undisputed worst of the worst. And you know what? I agree. Therefore, I think it is time we take a look at what makes Shiv the undisputed shitty person of the century. In my opinion, of course. Ladies, gentlemen, fellow Earthlings, it is time we talk about Tom Wambsgans.
Thank you, Greg.
Yes! 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 Fuck yeah!
Shiv's treatment of her husband Tom is one of the worst cases of manipulative mental and emotional abuse ever shown on TV. What did she do? Well, grab a seat and take a deep breath, because oh my god, it's about to get wild. Are you ready? Let's go. Leading up to their wedding, Shiv cheats on Tom multiple times with an ex during her work trips. Next, she forces Tom to sign an unfavorable prenup. And then, she invites the very ex she's cheating on him with to her wedding. She then goes ahead to confess to Tom about her cheating right in the middle of the reception party post-wedding ceremony while still wearing her wedding dress. And then, she goes, newsflash, I want an open relationship on their wedding night.
Oh my god!
It's not sure I'm a good fit for a monogamous marriage.
Right.
I mean, is that okay to say to you?
Of course. Yeah, I kind of wish. I guess maybe we talked about this before our wedding night.
By the way, did I mention that she was able to get away with all of these due to the massive power dynamic between her and Tom? Yeah, she abused that power dynamic alright. But oh no, we aren't anywhere near done. You see, for the most of their relationship, the open aspect of it was very one-sided, with Tom mostly choosing not to exercise his options outside his wife, while Shiv was having a few days out in the streets. However, further down the line in season 4, their relationship takes a turn for the worst after Tom decides to side with Logan over the siblings, and so he and Shiv go on a break. At this point, Tom does start to exercise his options based on their mutual agreements. So then you can imagine my bewilderment when Shiv gets mad and confronts Tom about him sleeping with other people. Like,
hell?
Are you kidding me? Do you know the amount of shameless hypocrisy it takes to get mad at someone for not only doing something you suggested, something you both agreed on, but for doing something that you yourself have been doing and are still doing? Like, what the hell? Now, there is a very big part of Shiv's character that explains this irrational behavior, and I will get to that in a minute. But for now, we need to keep the focus on our relationship with Tom. Because guess what? There is more! Shiv's mental abuse didn't stop there. On multiple occasions, she'd gaslight and even publicly humiliate Tom with little to no remorse. With one of the clearest examples of this happening in season 4, when Shiv and Tom hosted the pre-election party. Throughout the night, there were comments being made by the guests saying that Tom would be fired by Mattson once the Gojo deal was completed in his own party. And guess what? Shiv was one of the major players in stirring up this rumor during the party. Why? For the exact same reason as the previous incident we've discussed. She was trying to curry favor with Mattson and the guys at Gojo, and if that meant throwing her husband under the bus, so be it. Once again, she didn't care the impact her actions would have on anyone else, as long as it was to her benefit. And oh, guess what happened when Tom tried to confront her about it? She tried to gaslight him by telling him,
oh, it's just banter, it's nothing personal.
That is Shiv never taking accountability for her actions. It is never her fault. Many times, she manipulated Tom into doing a dirty work. One of the worst cases of this happened during Logan's initial bid to buy Pierce. Logan was notorious for dealing brutally with dissenting voices. It was always his way or the highway. Everyone knew this, and so everyone kept mute about their apprehensions regarding the deal. But Shiv thought that this deal was a big mistake, and in truth, she wasn't alone in this. However, at this point, she was next in line to succeed Logan as CEO, and she didn't want to risk a position by directly challenging Logan's decision. So what does she do? She forced Tom to relay a skepticism regarding the deal as his own, instead of doing it by herself. This leads to one of the most brutal abuses of power I have ever seen, with Logan forcing Tom and two others to grovel on all fours and fight for sausages like dogs. I kid you not.
Tom! Sit on the floor!
Seriously?
Yeah, it's a game. Boar on the floor.
I feel...
Get down! Four on the floor!
Guys. Four on the
Cow
floor!
Get down!
Cranked!
Four on the
Feed
floor!
Feed the piggies, guest
four
of honor!
On the floor!
That's it!
Oink for your sausages, piggy. Oink, oink. Oink for your sausages. Tom, oink.
Oink, 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 oink.
The last piggy to eat a sausage is the mole. Greg, oink! One.
I got it! Carl stole my sausage! Carl stole my sausage!
Too effing slow.
Eat up, piggies!
Shiv knew how bad Adat's temper could be. She knew and still sent her husband to do something she knew would totally backfire against his will. But fellow Earthlings, it gets even worse. While Tom was doing her dirty work and being treated like a dog as a result, at that very time, Shiv was somewhere else getting her pipes cleaned out by some awesome actors she had just met. While her husband was enduring the most humiliating experience of his life, something she caused, she was out there living her best life.
God damn it! You can't make this shit up!
Now, we have established that Shiv is incredibly selfish, manipulative, and abusive. But we also know that every single person in succession is repulsive and exhibits some or all of these traits to some degree. The thing is though, there is one thing that makes Shiv stand out from all the other candidates for worst character in succession. And that is the fact that, unlike every other candidate, Shiv actually believes she is a good person.
What?
I'm not kidding. This is what makes her actions so repulsive and her character so terrible. For the majority of the show, Shiv carries herself as someone who is morally superior to her brothers. And as we watch the show, we start to realize that her biggest character flaw is not that she is unable to see that she's abusive or manipulative, but that she finds it difficult to come to terms with the fact that, in fact, she is at the very least just as bad as her siblings. And that flaw is what leads to her, in effect, actually being worse than her brothers. Because a lot of her worst traits are a result of her doing everything in her power in order to avoid facing this very fact that she is just not a good person. That is why she'd regularly gaslight her husband and others. That is why she was so manipulative. That is why she forced Tom into an open relationship on the night of their wedding. Remember how I said I would explain why she got mad at Tom for sleeping with other people? This is why. See, she knew cheating on her fiancé and eventual husband was a shitty thing. But there was one problem. She really enjoyed it and didn't want to stop. But continuing to cheat would make her the bad person in the relationship. And Shiv, well, she's a good person. So she ambushed her husband on their wedding night and opened up their marriage, because by doing that, in her mind, she had now made things equal. Her husband could not sleep around as well, and so she no longer had to feel any guilt for her infidelity. But then a new problem arose. Tom simply refused to sleep with other people. That was a clear indication of something that he had said a couple of times, that he didn't actually want an open marriage, meaning Shiv was the one forcing this arrangement to exist just for her benefit, and therefore making her the bad person once again. And so, on multiple occasions, Shiv tried to get Tom to have some jiggy-jiggy with other women, even going as far as to set up a threesome with both of them and another woman at some point. But on every single occasion, Tom just refused. His constant refusal continued to fuel Shiv's guilt, and that is why she flipped out on him when she found out he was seeing other people during the trial separation. Because finally, she could point a finger at him and say to him all the things she imagined he would have said to her in her head when he found out she had been cheating on him. Finally, she could be like, ha, see, you are not better than me. Because finally, in her head, she wasn't the only bad one in the relationship. This has been another random thought session. Let me know if you agree with me in the comment section. Like and subscribe. Until next time, take care.